What Windows startup programs do I need? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Ask Leo is brought to you for free in part by the support of a bunch of patrons. To become a patron, to learn more and find out about patron exclusive benefits, visit askleo.com/patron. Here's the question. How do I determine what Windows startup programs I absolutely need to load? Do I really need all of my protection programs like virus and spyware to load at startup? Boy, if ever there was a question I wish I had an easy, obvious answer for, this would be it. The problem is that there is no minimum set of things you need to run at startup that I could tell you, because it's going to be different, not just for every machine, but for everybody. Different people run different software. Different people have different software installed on their machines. Different machines have different requirements for things to be run on startup. So I can't tell you what you do and don't need. I have some guidelines and some things to look at. And what I want to do in this video is walk you through a couple of the different places that you can start to look. So we'll start by firing up the task manager, which I'm going to do with a right click here and hit task manager and start in the alternate start menu, as it's called. Now you may find that your task manager looks more like this. This is the default view of task manager. It's only showing you the programs that you believe you have running. And right now I don't have any running. I just have Windows itself running. If I click on more details, then you get a sense for, yeah, there's a lot more running here than we might expect. For a system that is running nothing, that's doing nothing, there's a lot of software here that's running, and this is kind of what we're looking at. So over here on the startup tab, we get an opportunity to see what kinds of things are happening when we sign into our machine. Each one of these are things that you can turn off. These are things you can also use to make some other decisions. For example, Cortana is a great one. I'm going to disable Cortana, not going to uninstall or remove it or anything. I'm just going to right click on it and click on disable. And you can see now here that it's listed as disabled. That means that the next time I boot this machine, it won't run. Cortana won't start up. Dropbox, I use it. OneDrive, I use it. PowerShell, I'm actually not sure what this is doing, and I'm not going to touch things I don't understand. Skype, I had already disabled. And Windows security notifications, well, that I do want enabled, because security notifications are important, right? You want to see about those. You want to hear about those things. So even with just this really short list, we've given a clue as to what kinds of things you may or may not want to turn off or leave turned on in your startup. The things that you don't use, the things that you don't care about, the things you can identify as being unnecessary with whatever knowledge you have, those are things you can probably safely disable. Now, I'm actually going to suggest that in some cases, you may want to, instead of disabling them, go to Settings, Apps, and uninstall the program that installed them in the first place. If you find that you're not using the program that they represent, then the best way to actually get rid of this is to get rid of all of it. So if that means program X, which you used last maybe a year ago and you haven't used since, but it installed a startup entry so that there's a little piece of program X running every time you boot your machine, you could disable it, but if you're not using program X, uninstall the whole thing. If you find that the software is something that you use, say program X really is something that you find valuable, but having it start something up every time you reboot your machine just doesn't seem necessary to you, then yeah, that's a candidate for disabling the startup entry. The good news about disabling startup entries is that by and large, it's a safe thing to do. You can disable pretty much everything I have listed here. The downside of doing that is that some features may not work. For example, if I were to disable Dropbox, then Dropbox would stop synchronizing the files on my machine with the files in the Dropbox cloud and with any other machines I have Dropbox installed on. That's the synchronization service. You want that running. But you may find that for application X, there's a thing that it starts for no apparent reason. Go ahead, disable it. You may find at some point that some aspect of program X may work differently or may stop working, in which case you know, or at least can make a decision about whether or not you want to come back here and re-enable the entry. Now, you mentioned in the original question about your anti-malware. That's not listed here. And that's not listed here because my anti-malware tool is Windows Security. It's already running. It's part of the operating system. And in fact, we could take a look over here on the Services tab, which has a whole bunch of other things that are potentially running on your system. You can see many of them are stopped, some of them are running, but one of the ones that is running is this one way down here at the bottom that I believe should be called Windows Defender, Microsoft Defender Antivirus Service. That's not something you're going to find in your startup list because it's the Microsoft service that's doing that. However, one of the things that you might find in your startup list is a security tool that you installed yourself, a different security tool. A different security tool that, when Microsoft Defender sees you've installed another tool, it steps aside. It says, okay, this person wanted this other tool because they installed it, so I'm not going to come into conflict with it. I'm going to shut down, turn myself off. If your security software has a listing here in the startup entries, by all means, leave it running. You don't want to run the risk of not being protected because you didn't run something at startup. Now, I have to be completely clear here that disabling your security software in startup may or may not impact your security. Different tools work in different ways. Some may, in fact, work the same way as Microsoft's does and install themselves as a service. And the only thing they really have in the startup list here would be a notification app or a little helper app. But some of them start their primary function by being here in the startup list. You don't want to turn that off. The thing is, we don't know. When in doubt, leave it running. Just let it run. Now, the other thing that happens, and this is, I'll just call it annoying, is that you might go through the process of disabling one or more entries here, and then come back sometime later and find that they've been re-enabled or reinstalled or whatever, but they're back here impacting your startup. This can be annoying. And what it boils down to is some software is, I'll call it, so convinced of its own importance that it will use any of several different opportunities to reassert itself into the startup list. That can happen either because the software is just monitoring. The next time you run the software, it says, hey, you disabled my startup entry. I'm going to re-enable it again. Or more commonly, the next time you update that software, that update process may then, as part of the process, go through and update, quote unquote, update the startup process and re-enable it there as well. It's up to you as to whether or not these are things worth tracking down. Here's my bottom line, and it really is a question of, you should ask yourself, is all of this really worth it? My answer is kind of. I disable Skype. I disable Cortana. There's some random stuff I have disabled on my main machine. This is an example machine. On my main machine, the list is much, much longer. But it's not something I come back to often. It's not something I come back to see who turned themselves back on again, or after I've installed half a dozen different packages, I don't look after each one to see what got added to my startup list. Startup performance is one of those things where you can improve it. the best way to improve it, the easiest way to improve it that has benefits far beyond startup is, of course, to replace your existing old HDD, your hard disk, with an SSD that improves startup time dramatically and keeps your system running faster even after you've started up. The other is just acceptance. In other words, often, especially for machines that aren't mine, that aren't in my control, startup takes a while. So I let it take a while. I will start the machine and walk away, or I will sign into the machine and walk away, get some coffee, get something to drink, whatever. Sometimes that's the safest thing to do, because that way you know you're not turning off something important. But the bottom line is, I really don't think it's necessarily worth the time and effort to try and really spend a lot of time analyzing your startup beyond what I would call the obvious. And in this example, to me, the obvious things were Cortana and Skype. For you, that might be something else. I hope this was helpful. Hope this gives you some ideas, some places to look at, some things to look for, some decisions, or some data to make some decisions on your own. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/16440. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.